OpenCode plugins beat Claude Code at this one thing: complete workflow control. To just quickly show what I'm talking about on screen, is I've got the Claude Code documentation and OpenCode documentation side by side. And Claude Code only works with the bash command, where OpenCode gives you a lot more access to the actual app, the client, and shell commands. So you can actually customize your whole developer experience in OpenCode way more than you could in Claude Code. So if you're serious about automating your day workflow or changing it to suit your needs, this is probably the feature you can't afford to miss. Let's jump in. Right, how do you get started building your first plugin? Well, it's quite simple. You can either use in your global or your local per project. You just need to put in your .opencode folder, plugin, and then your name of your plugin. And once you've got that set up, you can put the code in your plugin.ts, or it can be a .js, and you can then just start it and start testing with your plugin. It's very that simple. And it's quite powerful because you can hook into different events. So let's have a quick look at what those events are. So for example, you could hook into a certain event, maybe before a message, and change the LM temperature for a certain LM if it's there. Or you can handle messages. Maybe the message context is too long and you've got a different way of refining context before it gets passed to a bigger model. You can then put that process in there. So to just get started, we're going to build a local plugin. I'm literally just going to copy the code that you see on screen here. Essentially, all this code is going to do is be using the plugin from OpenCode AI plugin, and that just allows us to have type safety when building this. And this will literally tell us when the session is idle. It will just say your code is done. Just jumping in. Again, I've got nothing here. I'm going to make a local project. I'm just going to go .new, and I'm just going to make my .opencode. Well, in this folder, I'm going to make plugin. It's singular, not plural. And then from that, I'm just literally going to call this one called notify.ts. And I'm literally going to import that. One thing you'll note, we've got these errors because, well, it's TypeScript. And I'm going to use bun. So literally just going to go to the .opencode folder, plugin, and I'm just going to run bun init. So initialize, and I'm just going to say plugin. It's fine. Great. And then I'm just going to go uninstall my plugin here, and once that's installed, everything should be working great and everything's picking up. Now, to see that if this is working, I'm just going to run OpenCode here. I'm just going to run a simple one and thumb the joke just so it finishes quicker.
Your code is done,
and we can see our plugin is working very quick and easy. It's a simple plugin that we made very far. One thing to note, if you are debugging, I think this is always important to understand where you can find the information. You can find the log files at these spots, and you can always monitor your log with the tail.f command. This is just important if you just want to understand what your plugin's actually doing. And I feel like it's always just important in the development process to get logs. Okay, on screen, I'm just showing quickly all the different types of events you can actually get in OpenCode. You can also find it in the OpenCode packages folder called SDK, and this will have the whole list. You can also use plugins to like connect with external API. I've actually made a different one. I'll probably show that after this, how I just plugged in every time I get a session idle that it sends me a message on Telegram that, hey, the code is done, go check it out. Then you can also add webhooks or polling to then actually use Telegram to interact with your OpenCode editor. So it's like the possibilities are quite endless here. Anyway, I'll probably just jump ahead to show you my Telegram integration so you can kind of get a feel of what that looks like. All right, I've jumped ahead now. I've just got this Telegram plugin that I made just for demonstration purposes, where I can just send a message on Telegram saying, hey, session idle, here's your last message, or your open session is idle, time to check your work. Very simple, but let's just see how this works. I actually have Telegram here. And let's see how this, you can see I've been testing this a bit. If we get my Telegram account here, I'm just gonna write a few things just so we can see when it comes back. All right, going to OpenCode again. We can see it's running there. Let's make this a bit bigger. And I'm just gonna say, tell me a joke again. And I'm gonna run that, and I'm gonna grab my Telegram. And we should see it pop up as soon as it's done. Quite instantaneous. You can see a bit above here, I was playing with other commands they could send to it, like send a command, start, give a status. Hopefully you guys have got a better feeling now how powerful plugins can be with OpenCode and the amount of customization you can actually use with plugins. So now you guys can see how you can integrate with external APIs, like send a message to Telegram, Slack, you name it. This is simply Claude Code can't do right now. OpenCode just gives you full control. That's one thing that OpenCode plugins beat Claude Code at, giving you total workflow control. What plugin would you build to automate your workflow? Drop down your ideas down below. And if you like this content, definitely hit that like and subscribe button. And let me know what you'd like to see next in the next videos. Thanks for watching. See you around.